Fishermen together with UPDF Marines last night and today morning mounted a search of two fishermen who drowned in water at the railway bridge connecting Jinja to Buikwe district. The duo of fishermen working at the Nile landing site that is on the fateful day went casting nets looking for fish but did not return home. Our reporter has more.
Emmanuel Magen, the landing site chairperson, revealed that there were three people on the boat. When they reached the railway bridge, the engine of the boat got mechanical faults. He explained that the deceased had life jackets on the boat, but they had not worn them.
Right now, some of our members, the boys whom we are working with here, yesterday at 5 o'clock in the evening, when they were using our boats here, the boat with the engine, where they were traveling, going up across the other old bridge, railway bridge. After crossing railway bridge, the engine got a problem. Then it stopped. The engine stopped working. Eventually, the water brought them back slowly, until they reached the railway bridge. There is when the boat went down.
The survivor and the captain of the boat, in fear, revealed that they were going to lay the nets when the engine of the boat suddenly stopped working. He added that he tried to save his colleagues, but due to the high pressure of the waters, even the bowing stick was broken. Locals applauded UPDF Marines who are guarding all the bridges and the power dams, saying they always rescue them. At around midday, all the bodies were recovered. Peter Opado, a fisherman at the landing site, says the boat had a faulty engine. The two bodies have been identified as Ismail Opel, 36, from Paikwach, and Muzamiru Mukiri, 47, from Yumbe. Mukiri was taken to Jinja Muslim Cemetery for burial, while Opel's body has been taken back to his ancestral home in Paikwach district. On 30th August last year, a similar incident happened in the same area after a boat belonging to Hassan Awel, an investor, was smashed into the turbines of Kira Power Dam, with three people dying on the spot. Story by Emmanuel Balukusa for the news.